If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, subscribe right now. Just click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get notifications of my upcoming videos. Hey guys, what's up? Today we will see how to make this drop down menu with the help of HTML and CSS only. No JavaScript is required because we will be doing some manipulations in the CSS code to achieve this task. So let's begin with the code. So beginning with the HTML file, give it a title whichever you like. I'm just giving drop down menu, and then giving a link to a style sheet which will be the CSS style.css. Now for the menus, we will be creating an unordered list, so I'm using the UL tags, and to display the contents on the screen we will be using the li, and between the anchor tags we will place our content so that the person who will be clicking on the button may jump to the another page or maybe jump to a particular section on the same page. So this will be achieved by the anchor tags. So I'm just giving some menus. So now just copy pasting the same thing, and I'll change the content in between. So now to achieve the sub menus, what we will do is we will place an unordered list between the li opening and closing tags of the main menus. That is, for suppose now here I'm be placing an unordered list between the opening and closing li tags of the about, and here I will write the sub menu whichever I want below this using the same li tags and the anchor tags to give the link. So doing again the same thing, copy pasting the same line, changing the content of it. So now doing the same thing for all the sub menus. So I'll speed up the process here. So this finishes our HTML part. Now without CSS, it wouldn't be looking even close to a drop down menu. Let's see. Now one more thing we can add is that arrow I had, right, that shows that it has a drop down menu. So how to get that? Just go on Google, type font awesome CDN. These fonts will be provided by font awesomes. So just go on the bootstrap CDN, click the arrow here, copy the HTML link and then paste it between your head tags. Remove the integrity part, we don't need that. Now to use these arrows on your HTML page, what you have to do is you have to create an I tag, and in that I tag you have to give a class which will be fa space fa dash caret dash down. So what this will do is it will give you that arrow on that HTML page. See, now you can see that. So now I'll just copy it and paste it to the adjacent of all the menus we have. So now after we have our HTML form ready, let's begin with the CSS now. So beginning with the body tag first, we will set an image on the background. And make sure that it doesn't repeat, that is only one image is present on whole screen. Giving it the background size to cover, font family to sans serif, and changing the text color to white. Now for the first UL which we'll have, we'll set the margin to 0, padding to 0 and list style to none. So if you remember, previously the list style was to circle. We used to see the circles on the line. So we don't want that, so we'll set the list style to none here. So now setting up the UL li, which are the menus which we will be having. So for that I am setting the margin to 2 pixels, float to left, height to 40 pixels and width to 250 pixels. These values totally depend upon you. However you want to change them, you can customize them. setting the background color to a hex value, giving it a line height, font size, and text aligned to center. And also a little opacity looks good, so setting the opacity to 0.8. After refresh, you will see something like this. So as you saw, there was an underline below all the menus and the submenus as well. So that doesn't look good. So for that, we will use ULLIA, the A part, and we will set the text decoration to none so that all the underline and all things will be gone. We will set the color of all the menus to white and display to block. Yeah, so this looks pretty decent now. So now on the hover effect, we will change the background color to black and we will keep a transition of 0.7 second so it looks good. Now we don't want a submenu to be shown unless the mouse pointer enters the menu. So to do that, what we will do is first we'll write ULLI. Now what this is, we will be accessing our submenus by this ULLI, which are the menu, and below that again UL and LI, which are the submenus. So now we will set margin to 0 and display to none. So now it won't display any of the submenu. Now what do we want? That on the hover of that mouse on that menu, we want to show only that submenu. So to do that, we will do ULLI colon hover ULLI. And here we will set the display to block. So now as you can see, we get the submenu only if the mouse enters to that particular menu. So this is what we want, right? So we have achieved this by using some manipulations in the CSS only. Now there was quite a little space between the font of that dropdown and the text we had. So it doesn't look much good. So what we will do is we will try to insert some space between the text and the font. And how we are going to achieve is, we will write &NBSP and end it with semicolon towards adjacent to our menus. Now what is this NBSP? It's basically non-breaking space. It will provide a space between the menu and the font which we had. Let's check it out. Yeah, so now this looks awesome. So we'll just copy and paste on all the menus. And there it is. You have your form ready in just 10 minutes. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any doubt, go ahead and ask me in the comment section. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. It encourages us a lot. So thank you for watching. And stay tuned for more amazing videos. Bye bye.